uninterpreted of those about her, unreadable even to her husband, strangely changed from the warm-faced who had bade Tom Stormont Godspeed in his quest for gold years ago. Her gift of wise, yet not oppressive, reticence was the chief outlined evidence of it. The only other apparent testimony was the sleepless eyes that watched the misty moon wheel away behind the hills, and the southern cross fade into the morning, and the slow lips that murmured hidden thoughts to the waves of the coral sea. But these things were not seen by any eye save God's. She distrusted her husband. She knew some evil had been done her, but she could not surely define it, and she had not by which to accuse. She also had come to know that his character was unworthy, and that there was some dark thing in his life. But what? Once he had dared to tax her with cherishing a memory that was not in keeping with her wifely duty, but he was met by such a vehemence of suggestive and icy scorn that he never repeated his offense. He had bought a hoped-for happiness at a tremendous cost. Fate held a lien on his existence. Foreclosure must occur. It was peculiar that he felt no shiver of warning pass through him at the moment when Gustave Flavelle appeared in his doorway, delivering a note of introduction that the agent at the harbor of the Swallow had given him. On the advice of Legrève, the Frenchman had told the agent just who he was. No criminal, no convict, no enemy on the morality of Anglo-Saxon dispensation, but a gentleman of France, companion of Henry Rochefort and Felix Rastoul, sent Hugger Mugger out of his native country to rot in a savage island of the south. At Lebanon, he could wait, she said, until money came, until through the aid of sympathizers in Sydney, he could sail again for Europe. She was sure that Rothsay Heckler would be flattered by the association. Besides, she insisted, it suited her that Gustave Flavelle should find his home for a time at Lebanon. Gustave Flavelle had views in his chivalric heart regarding Legrève, which as yet he did not make definitely clear to her. He consented to seek a position of Rothsay Heckler. It was as she said, the planter, slave dealer, murderer as he was, had sensibilities of a pleasing kind. Like many others of his class, he was far from averse to having in his employ, as under-manager, the famous French novelist and politician. Gustave Flavelle did not hide from the planter the fact that he owed his escape to a woman whom he had left in a hut in the hills near the Hebron Falls, and to whom he was attached by all the ties of gratitude and affection. This again was on the advice of Legrève. The Frenchman told the story airily,